races right now, so it's time to prepare the cart for the next time out. And just wanted to share with you a little bit about what I do to get ready to go. There's a lot of great videos out on YouTube about how to prepare a race car. And speaking as a guy who's prepared everything from go-karts up to an Indy car for just a couple of days, but hey, I have worked on an Indy car and pretty much everything in between, I can tell you that there's four priorities that you need to be thinking about when you get ready to go and prepare a race car. The first one, of course, is safety. You want to do everything with an eye towards safety. You know, speed doesn't kill, it's that hit at the very end that does. So you want to eliminate those hits if all possible, at least from a reliability standpoint, which brings me to my next word, reliability. To finish first you must finish, and so you want to make sure that you've got great reliability, that parts aren't falling off, that are breaking or anything like that. So reliability is the next thing on the list. Beyond that, performance comes next. Yes, you need to go and have a machine that's quick, but you also need reliability, and of course then you need safety, and last but not least, you need something that's pretty. Now, pretty is pretty low on my list, but for other guys, it's really big. So follow me as I go in. I'm not going to say a whole lot, but the big deal for me is go through, clean everything up just as clean as I can possibly get it, and then start going back in, checking nuts and bolts, making sure they're tight, looking for cracks, all of those kinds of things. So I hope this makes sense, and let's get after it. Wrap this up for part one of how to prepare your shifter cart. The thing I want to remind you of is strip everything down that you can and then go ahead, get it clean, inspect things, and if you have any doubts at all about whether a part's any good, you can always use what I call the flotation test. If you don't know what the flotation test is, that's where you take the part that you're really wondering about whether it's any good or not, take it down to the lake and throw it into the lake. If it floats, it's good. If it sinks, go buy a new part and replace it. That's the best advice I can give you. Okay, stay around for part two, which will be about reassembling this cart, where I show you some of the tricks of the trade of putting this thing back together again so that we're ready to hit the track. Thanks for joining. I hope you enjoyed it. We'll talk to you soon.